Hello, everyone. Mike Arnold here, co-founder of Path Trading Partners, along with Bob Iacino. By the way, if you're new here and you happen to click on the videos, please consider subscribing, liking, disliking a video, leaving a comment, and ringing the bell. Longer term subscribers, please consider at some point a donation, or at least at a minimum, liking and disliking the videos. And leaving comments so we can get this information out to more people. So uranium, this is the Global X Uranium ETF. Big, huge move. So we had to run up earlier in September till about the middle of September. Nice pullback. I have on the harmonic levels. We use harmonics and not Fibonacci here. 12.5% increments if you're new here. Let me show you real quick, and you can pause the video. I actually have instruction on how to set this up. Other videos below, but there's here 12.5% increments. Just wanted to touch on that. Coming back to that 50% level, really nice sideways consolidation. Rotation zone on the daily going flat. Now the breakout move above, you can see here on the weekly. We use this concept called the weekly rotation zone to watch for pullbacks. Got the pullback right to the top of the weekly rotation zone at that 50 and the strong rotation back up. But that's all hindsight. Why am I talking about this? Here are the next targets, the upside. Very minor target is, we're probably already there in after hours, about 2730. Then we're watching 2072, 3016, 3159. Okay, one of the things we do here on this channel is help people project the future prices. Those are some of the short-term ones. I'm going back to all the way the major low on the 16th of March from 2020. And I'm using my harmonic projections, and we use a 12.5% and 25% to help figure out, all right, above. We already had 3016, 3144. Now I have a level, a cluster. When you have multiple things lining up at the same point, it's called a cluster, and that's, you should not ignore clusters. 3144 to about 3155, then 3416 are your next key levels that we can project. Why could this keep going? Well, there's a number of fundamental reasons from a commodity standpoint, from a shortage in uranium. And here's the big picture. Let me go out to a monthly chart. So this is the uranium ETF, but here's the monthly chart. Is there room to run up on the upside? Yes, there is. There is substantial room to the upside with some other key stopping points, but let's get through this little blip first. Key other levels I'd watch is about 3580. I'm just going to rattle some off right now. About 4270. Major area about 4750. But right now, with this kind of price action, we have, even with pullbacks, there is a massive levels to watch to the upside. Your major support now, even on a bigger pullback, is 2032. On the weekly, we've already come off that support. So on any pullback, it's now buying. This was resistance, is now becoming support. You have the daily rotation zone there. So even if you're a pullback anywhere between about 2510 to about 2450, that is just a key buying zone based off the daily. And the weekly, you can see here, supported with the rotation zone on the weekly. But with this kind of price action, looks like a lot of funds are rolling into this also. So I'm going to keep watching for continued price action higher. Cannot give investment advice, but this is something to start watching. If there are pullbacks and you're bullish in the commodity sector and specifically on uranium, pullbacks will continue to be a buy for the near-term future. And I will talk to everyone later. Bye for now.